This is an equation of a circle. However, this is not the standard form yet because we see the x twice, here and here, and we also see the y twice, here and here, and notice that we do have the x being squared plus y being squared. We are going to complete the square twice, one time for x, the other one for y, so that we can write this equation into the standard form of a circle, and then we can figure out the center and the radius of the circle. So let's make that happen. And first of all, we have to focus on x squared plus bx. So this and that together, let's write it down first. Write down x squared minus 12x, just these two terms first. And then we leave a space for a special someone. And then we'll write down the y plus the y squared, and then plus 2y. And we also leave a space for the special someone. And then we bring this down, equals to 27. So this is pretty much a setup. And now you know what's that space for, right? It's for the magic number for the x and also the y. And let's do this first for the x. Right here, we have to remember how to find out that magic number. It's 1/2 times the b value, 1/2 times the b value, namely the number in front of the x in this case, which is negative 12. So let's write that down. And then we put this in the parentheses and square that. 1/2 times negative 12 is negative 6. And then we square this. Negative 6 squared will give us 36. And this is the magical number. This is the number that belongs to here. It has a special spot, right? And we are going to add 36. And be sure you add the magic number on both sides. So right here, I will also add 36. And then we are going to do the same thing for y. So let's find that special someone for y. And the b value here is the number in front of the y, which is positive 2. So let's write that down. 1/2 times 2, and then we square that. 1/2 of 2 is 1, and then we square that. 1 squared is 1. And this number, it's a special number for the y. So we add 1 here, and we add 1 here. Okay, so we are ready to go. Because if you look at these three terms right here, for the x, we can write this as something to the second power. We can factor it, and this right here is going to be x minus 6 times x minus 6. Because negative 6 times negative 6 will give us positive 36. Negative 6 minus 6 will give us negative 12. So this right here is x minus 6. And then don't forget to bring down the plus. And then for y squared plus 2y plus 1, we can also write it as something to the second power. In this case, it will be y plus 1 to the second power. Okay, so this is what we have. And a little hint right here is that this minus 6, it's going to be the number before we square it. So we have the minus 6 right here. And this positive 1 is this positive 1 in blue, the number before we square it. Or you can just factor it, up to you however you want to do it. And then at the end here, 27 plus 36 is 63. And then plus 1 is 64. So now, this right here is the standard form of the circle. So let me just label it. This is the standard form, which we got it already, right? And can we figure out the center? And let's figure this out right here. The center, it's going to be what? Positive 6 and negative 1. Positive 6, negative 1. Remember, it's the opposite. Okay, what you see inside of the parentheses, it's the opposite. It's x minus 6 right here, but it's actually just a 6. And then this is y plus 1, but it's actually negative 1. And then for the radius, this right here, look at this. This is 64, but then don't look at 64 as 64. Look at 64 as square root of 64, and then square. And we know square root of 64 is 8. So the radius is actually 8. And now we have the information. The center is 6, negative 1, and the radius is 8. Okay, that's the These are the most two important information for the circle. And I know you guys can draw a circle, and you just have to know where is the center of the circle and how big is that circle. And if you want to make a graph on this, I will leave that to you. But as of now, this is it.